Williams Butler Wild Bill Hickok was born in 1838 in Troy Grove, Illinois. Hickok drifted west. He worked at stage stations on the Overland Trail, scouted for the Union Army during the Civil War, and served for a time as the marshal of the original Kansas cattle town, Abilene. Newspapermen and Western writers had dubbed Hickok Wild Bill and had written a number of vastly exaggerated stories about him. He had traveled briefly with Buffalo Bill Cody's Wild West Show. By the time Hickok headed for Deadwood to join the gold rush in June 1876, he was a living legend. The truth was much less than the legend. Wild Bill had recently married. His eyesight was failing and he was in financial difficulty. His stage career with Buffalo Bill Cody had failed. The cowtowns didn't need gunslinging marshals. Gambling in the mining camps might bring in a few dollars. Gambling was what Hickok was doing when Jack McCall shot him in Saloon No. 10 on August the 2nd of 1876. Wild Bill had spent a month in Deadwood. Virtually his only contribution to Deadwood was to die here. He was buried in the original cemetery at Ingleside. Mount Moriah Cemetery stands as living proof that the dead Wild Bill was more valuable to Deadwood than a live one. Wild Bill's reburial on Mount Moriah in 1879 was accompanied with great ceremony. Old friends Colorado Charlie and Steve Utter returned to assist. By the 1890s, Wild Bill's grave was a major Deadwood attraction. The wooden headboard on his grave was hacked to pieces by souvenir hunters. Surrounded by an iron fence, a bust of Wild Bill on a stone pedestal replaced it. This was also soon vandalized. Almost everyone, it seemed, wanted a piece of Wild Bill. The inscription on the base added to the Wild Bill mystique. It included the passage, "Custer was lonely without him." In 1902, a life-size sandstone statue was completed by a sculptor named Reardon. Higher fences and wire made no difference. By the end of World War II, it had been thoroughly vandalized, and it was retired to the Adams Museum. Today, Wild Bill has to be content with this crypt and a simpler granite slab. Mount Moriah's caretaker has given up on statues. For Deadwood, the story of Wild Bill dead has been longer and more interesting than the story of Wild Bill alive.